Now let's investigate which blade length gives the biggest voltage output from our STELR wind turbine generator. Small, medium, or large? Let's start with two long blades at 45 degrees. Let's turn on the wind and see what happens. And remember to read your results from the multimeter and don't forget to write them down. Now, try the other two lengths.
Did you know that each blade of the wind turbine works in unison together to spread the workload, making the turbine more energy efficient?
Energy efficiency is everywhere in nature. For example, the hummingbird. The hummingbird shifts its body weight through upstroke and downstroke and has this thing called elastic recoil, kind of like a rubber band, which means that its muscles don't get tired. So it's able to hover and hover endlessly without using as much energy as what it normally would if it was flapping. This design is copied in wind turbines all around the world.
How'd you go? Now, as you can see from my results, the shorter blades worked best for me and gave the biggest voltage. Now, why do you think that might be? One idea I have is that maybe it actually uses less energy to turn around these tiny blades than it does when it's got the long blades on. We might have to do some more reading to see.